Hey guys, Uncle Michael here from UnfilteredGamer.com, and currently we have Drew Nolasco with the Transformers Trading Card Game by Wizards of the Coast. He's going to give us a little bit more of an introduction as to what it's going to be about.
Absolutely. Hey everyone. So the Transformers Trading Card Game is an action battling card game where you get to create a team of Transformers characters and duke it out with your opponent. Perhaps the single coolest thing about this is that the cards for characters are gigantic. They're all this big, and they all convert from alt mode to bot mode and back. Every single one of the character cards is foil, and these are like the biggest trait character cards ever. When you build your team of Transformers characters, you also build a deck, you can see it here, of battle cards. Those are actions and equipment. So like the Matrix of Leadership is an equipment card in this deck of standard sized cards that you put on one of the larger character cards.
And so it's going to be a two-player right game where you're going back and forth with each other.
Exactly.
And hopefully more and more content is going to come out where you can actually kind of make your own deck, basically, right?
So this starter set has four characters. This is for two players to learn. The booster packs have one random character card and seven of the battle cards. So you can help build your own deck.
Okay, cool. So that is basically what it's going to be. It's basically a Transformers trading card game. What would you say it's similar to for people that don't know about it, Billy?
So interestingly, we created a system specifically for Transformers. So this is an entirely new game system. Our design philosophy here was keep the system rules very, very easy to grok. So even a youngster could learn the system rules and then layer in the game complexity via the card mechanics. So there's a lot of deck building opportunities here. You can build decks that are alt mode focused, like I built the truck deck. It's Optimus Prime, it's Ironhide, and it cares about my characters turning into trucks. Or you can build a deck that combos out a little bit more, like this character, Autobot Cosmos. He cares about when you shuffle your deck, and he gets actually a super powerful effect when you shuffle while he's attacking. So that deck looks for you to more line up specific attacks. So there's a lot of possible options for building a deck that suits your gameplay.
So is this what it is currently available? Is the starter set and the first set of packs you can purchase?
This comes out September 28th in the U.S., and it comes out a little bit later than that rest of the world.
Okay, great. And is there going to be more stuff coming out anytime soon? Yeah, there will be, obviously. Awesome.
So this pulls from the Generations line, which is sort of the evergreen line of Transformers characters. And that means we can pull in characters from all across the universe. Ironhide, Bumblebee, and Red Alert, very popular characters, well-known. But we can also pull in characters that are perhaps a little bit more obscure or haven't had a toy made for them recently that Transformers fans will be really jazzed. Like the convention edition that we're selling here today features Slipstream, who is Starscream's clone and is the other air commander for the Decepticons. Kind of an obscure character, but we can do that. And we can do that all the time.
Well, that's awesome. Okay, and last thing before you go, so I know you got some other stuff to do and other interviews. Where can we purchase this at? And once again, when is it going to be released?
So it's available widely in your local retail store, in your local game store, September 28th for both the Autobots starter set and the booster packs.
Awesome, thank you very much. Mike Rourke from Unfiltered Gamer here again, and I'll be looking forward to seeing you guys next time. Hey guys, welcome back to the Unfiltered Gamer interview here at Comic-Con 2018. I'm here with Hugh McMullen, Communications Director of Wizards of the Coast, and we're going to be talking about the 2019 core set of Magic the Gathering, a game I used to play quite fluently, but I'm a little behind, so he's going to catch us up with the core Magic set.
So every summer we do a core set, and what that is a set that's kind of streamlined and vivid. It's a great jumping on point for either new players or players who haven't played in a while, like yourself.
Yeah.
It's got all the classic fantasy favorites. You got your dragons, you got your angels, you got your sphinxes, you got your wizards, all everything you might want.
And if I remember about the core set, it has all the original cards, or a lot of the cards that come back that were not in play, and you can play them as standard once again. So if you have a favorite card, it can come back into the core set, along with some new ones now, as opposed to the last 10 years they've been making new stuff.
So an example of an old favorite that's been around forever is one of my favorite cards when I was a kid, Llanowar Elves.
One for a tavern?
Little elf that gives you more resources. He's really cute, but now he has new art, so
awesome.
That's cool. And then also we have new cards, the Elder Dragons. New versions of the Elder Dragons are in this set, including Nicol Bolas, our big bad, the Darth Vader of Magic.
I like the Nicol Bolas. I remember the Magic card Planeswalker, the first one. That one was nasty. Right. You were also saying something about a set of cards you're going to get. It's not like a starter deck. It's like something else, like an introductory deck you're talking about?
Yeah, so in Magic now we have Planeswalker decks. And with the core set, we have five Planeswalker decks. And what is great about Planeswalker decks is you are guaranteed a Planeswalker. a nice shiny one at the front of the box, and a 60-card deck specifically designed to work with that Planeswalker.
So these new Planeswalkers are even cooler than the original starting decks, right? Like, those players who just started wanting to get into it now, like, I was like, eh, I've already had those cards, you know? But now the Planeswalker, that might make me even more enticed to pick it up.
Yep. So, they're on sale at your local game store or your Targets, your Walmarts, things like that.
And the 2009 set is currently out right now. You just pick it up pretty much at any card shop, right?
Yep.
Any shop you want, pick it up. Well, thank you very much, Hugh, from Wizards of the Coast, Magic the Gathering. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. And as always, I look forward to seeing you guys next time. Hey guys, welcome back to another Unfiltered Gamer board and card game review. I'm here with Kyle today, and he's running Bandai's booth, and he is part of TC's Rockets here in San Diego, a comic book and card shop. They do a bunch of different tournaments and whatnot, as far as I'm aware, Magic and all that kind of stuff. And they're going to talk a little bit about the Dragon Ball Z and maybe a little bit about the comic book shop as well.
Oh yeah, so we run a comic book shop over in La Mesa. It focuses on toys, comics, and essentially any type of trading card game. So we do Magic the Gathering, Pokemon, and the Dragon Ball card game. Essentially, we have guys in there every day playing it, sweating it out, trying to become the best at their card game, whether it's Pokemon or Magic or Dragon Ball. Aside from that, we have like probably the most toy selection as far as like Marvel Legends. We have a lot of vintage Star Wars figures as well. And then we're just a normal comic book shop. We have new books, old books, plenty of backstock if anyone ever interested in that. As far as the Dragon Ball goes, they've actually released this new set. It's really good. They've introduced a lot of new mechanics to slow it down for players. A lot of the problems have been it's been too similar to Hearthstone, has been the complaints. This is really making it.
That's a complaint? I love that game.
Well, the thing is, it's like, if I'm going to play
you
this,
want something different,
why
right?
wouldn't I just play Hearthstone? So this is different, finally. It's really slowing down the game, making it to where your turn is your turn instead of, all right, well, I'm going to do a bunch of stuff on your turn instead.
Because I remember playing this game a while ago, and it was very different. I mean, this is like the new set, right? This is the whole, everything's been recreated now.
Oh, yeah. So this is actually the redux of the entire Dragon Ball game. There's an older one done by a different company, Panini.
Yeah.
This is completely new. They've redone everything. They've really solved a lot of the problems that typical TCG games have of being like a resource-based of, oh, I'm mana screwed, or, oh, I didn't draw the particular cards. This game's really solved that by making it very intuitive. If you ever need a resource card, any card in your hand can be, boom, instead of doing its effect, I can discard it for resources, stuff like that. Anyone who knows TCG games, that's a common issue.
I need to get my hands into a copy of this. I liked Magic the Gathering. I played Yu-Gi-Oh!
Oh, yeah.
Would you say this one's better, or in your opinion?
So if you're a diehard Dragon Ball Z game, this game is hands down better than any of the Pokemon expansions that they've released, any of the Magic expansions they've released. If you're like really into Dragon Ball, you're really into the anime, you're really up on the lore, it's a nostalgia trip from Pack 1. Every single card has its own flavor. The artwork is super unique. It's very exhilarating, very powerful artwork. If you're just a casual card game player, you'd love it as well because it's very easy to jump into. The card game has very, very simple phasing. Everything is very detailed and very descriptive in far as like the rules go like that. And other than that, like, yeah, it's a great game for new players and old players of the Dragon Ball franchise.
Awesome. Well, thank you for taking the time, Kyle, and showing us the game. If you guys are in the San Diego area and you want to check out TC's Rockets, go ahead and go in there and pick up a comic book or even, well, I got figures and all this other great stuff.
Figurines, comic books, trading cards.
Or even play some Magic, right? Competitive Magic.
The
friendly local card game shop is very important to us in the board gaming community. And so getting a little interview with you guys, as well as a little bit of Bandai's new stuff is cool as well. Hopefully I'll get a chance to check out the Dragon Ball Z card game.
Oh, yeah.
I played the original one, and that was pretty fun. Hopefully this one looks better. So I'm interested in seeing what this is going to be about. All right, guys, well, thank you very much for the interview. I appreciate it. Where is your store located? Really quick in San Diego, where?
Oh, it's over in La Mesa off Parkway Drive and Fletcher. It's a great location. Anyone's welcome to come down. We have gaming space available, table space always.
And if you want, you can go pick up Dragon Ball card game. I'm guessing pretty much any friendly trading card game store, I imagine.
Yeah, you can pick it up pretty much anywhere. A lot of stores have special deals on it. I know our store, we do a 3-for-10 value on it. It's the best you'll find in San Diego.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys. And as always, we look forward to seeing you guys next time.